Elon Musk just outlined his plan to start a colony on Mars.
But do his plans include his two brand new adult children?
Find out more on
Muskwatch now.
Muskwatch. It's Musky.
That was pretty good. If there's one thing we know Elon Musk wants, it's not us as his sons. If there's two things we know that he wants, it's to get our collective asses to Mars. A major part of his vision for the future is to turn humanity into a multi-world species to protect us from extinction, like those dumbass dinosaurs.
Yeah, come on, Musk, you got what you wanted, now give these people air.
See you at the party, Elon.
But as he wrote in a recently published paper, one of the biggest hurdles is the price tag.
Ugh, so expensive, space?
Quoth the Elon, quote, "You cannot create a self-sustaining civilization if the ticket price is 10 billion per person," end quote me.
In fact, one of the goals for SpaceX is to lower the price to transport someone to Mars to a mere $200,000 per person, which is the average price of an avocado toast. Am I right, millennials?
Millennial slam!
Oh, you got dunked on in an article. Grown-ups hate ya.
Quote, "It's a bit tricky because we have to figure out how to improve the cost of trips to Mars by 5,000,000%. End quote the daddy in the paper. I mean, he didn't tell us, but that would have been great.
I just have to assume he doesn't tell any of his sons anything in person, just gives them all papers in general. Anyway, the plan is basically three parts that includes reusable spacecraft, the ability to refuel in orbit, and then the ability to produce fuel on Mars.
SpaceX is also developing interplanetary spacecraft that could bring 100 passengers to Mars at a time, which we'd love a seat on, just saying.
Or even a love seat. Or maybe a couch so we can spread out. Anyway,
I'm gonna fix my ear.
And while Elon Musk wants to start a sustainable colony on Mars, there's a campaign to create the first sovereign nation to be located in Earth's orbit.
It's called the Kingdom of Asgardia.
Ugh.
Dude, it's perfect. I'm gonna be its prince.
It's boy prince.
Yes, and it was founded in late 2016 by a nonprofit NGO, but will have the first space launch this year.
What are they gonna launch exactly? Like a space habitat? Some monument that's gonna pave the way for generations of humans living in space?
They're going to launch a mini satellite consisting of a 512 gigabyte hard drive containing information on their first 1.5 million citizens, and that's it.
Yeah, so the Kingdom of Asgardia, which is obviously backed by Russian billionaire Igor Ashurbeli, will start its history by launching a hard drive with half the storage space of a base model PS4, you dummies.
Get a PS4 Pro!
You can just, they sell them for cheaper on like Newegg, what are you doing?
The purpose of the country is to be a spacefaring nation which will protect the Earth from external threats like meteors.
Asgardian citizens are voting this year on a constitution to flesh out their future government, which will start as a constitutional monarchy because one thing kings love doing is abdicating power for the greater good of their citizens. Especially in space, no one's ever willing to give up control of their tightly held throne in space. That'll end great.
And while the mini-sat that they're launching will burn up in the atmosphere in a few years, we're sure that the nation of Asgardia will live forever.
Up next, we have drama in the world of advertising, and no, we're not talking about Mad Men! Now, Audi recently unveiled a billboard in Berlin for their all-new electric vehicle with the caption, "Musk have."
Oh no, you can't do that! You can't do that to our dad. Although the Audi electric vehicle does look pretty cool, it will never be a Tesla. I mean, it doesn't even play Monty Python skits on demand.
Wait, do Teslas do that now?
Yeah!
What?
Didn't you know? Papa Elon tweeted, "In the US, you can ask your Tesla to play any Monty Python or other comedy skit. Doesn't work outside the US yet."
That's, I mean, cool. Honestly, it makes sense because no one outside the US is funny.
Your move, Audi.
I bet Audis don't even have storage space for legions of venomous bits either.
Yeah.
What do they have? A trunk?
And what vehicle has room for venomous bits and was just awarded a perfect safety rating? Perfect, tremendous safety rating from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration.
The Tesla Model X, baby! Oh, hold on.
They can just add that in post.
I'm post now.
Another win for our dad. Suck it, Audi! Woo!
That was actually pretty good.
Right up in the mic.
Okay, now before we go, it's time for your must-see moment of the week.
Ah! Wait. There's a hot new script floating around Hollywood about Elon Musk called The Man from Tomorrow.
Or Future Daddy.
It's supposed to be a sort of social network-like take on Musk's life.
Now, I'd rather it be sort of like an action film where Elon has to punch a bunch of henchmen in order to rescue his two adult sons.
Played by us.
Call us, Hollywood.
Call us.
Dad. And that's all the time we have for this
wait,
episode.
Wait, Dad. Who's gonna play him?
Oh, who should play Elon Musk? Keanu Reeves. I think that could be really cool, where instead of a dog, he's like trying to rescue his adult sons. But
played by us.
Yes, of course. It's not, I mean, there's no other way.
No.
It could possibly work.
No. Or JGL.
Ooh, I could see JGL more, just because, like Elon, he's got a bod that just won't quit. I don't want to misrepresent dad on film. If you don't think your own dad is hot, you're not a good child. And that's all the time we have for this episode of Muskwatch. It's that time again for the age-old tradition, which we so love.
Bye!
Thank you so much for watching Muskwatch. We love making it. And we love you watching it.
We do. Make sure you tweet us your best musky stories at SciFile, at Dan Casey, and at Nerdist with the hashtag Muskwatch!
Oh!
My guitar broke.